Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see. Beauty that made this heart adore you. Hope of a life spent with you. Here I am to worship. Here I to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether loving, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. King of all days, oh so high. I'll never know how much it cost to see my sin upon that cross. I'll never know how much it cost to see my sin.
Here again. The last time I was with you, we were thinking and talking about remembrance at the beginning of November. At this end of the month, in the church calendar, there's a festival of Christ the King. We celebrated it this last Sunday from the parish church in Croton. Some of the children from Croton will know this because you were involved, and if that was you, thank you so much. The parish church in Croton is named for Christ, Christ Church Croton, and in 12 months' time it will be 150 years old. If you're not from Croton, do you know who your parish church is named for and how old your parish church is? Maybe you can find out. At our festival service last Sunday, we used the same Bible reading we're all going to hear today about Jesus coming to sort the sheep from the goats. One of my friends bought some new sheep just recently and a couple of pigs. She had to do a bit of sorting to make sure the pigs didn't get mixed up with the sheep. I wonder why Jesus was sorting sheep and goats. Andrew's going to join us today, and I expect he'll have an explanation for us. Let's get started. Have you got your candle? Then we'll begin our worship. The Lord be with you. We light our candle to remind us that Jesus is the light of the world. Let's remember why we're gathered here. Loving God, we're here to worship you, to sing your praise, to listen to your word, and to pray to you in faith. Let's say together all that we believe. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, now let's hear about Jesus and those sheep and goats. Children from Norley School are going to tell us the story.
Jesus said, "When the Son of Man comes in glory, the whole world will be gathered before him, and he will separate people as a shepherd separates sheep from goats. He will put the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. He will say to those on his right, 'Come, you are blessed by my Father, for I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me. I was naked and you gave me clothing. I was sick and you took care of me. I was in prison and you visited me.' The sheep will answer, 'When did we see you hungry and give you food, or thirsty and give you a drink? When did we meet you as a stranger and welcome you, or see you naked and give you clothing? When did we see you sick or in prison and visit you?' The king will say, 'Whatever you did to the least important members of my family, you did it to me.' Then he'll say to those on his left, 'Get out, worthless goats. You are good for nothing, for I was hungry and you gave me no food. I was thirsty and you gave me no drink. I was a stranger and you did not welcome me. I was naked and you did not give me clothing. I was sick and in prison and you did not visit me.' The goats will answer, 'When did we see you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or sick in prison and did not take care of you?' He will answer, 'Because you did not do it for the people in need. You did not do it to me.' And the goats will be sent to eternal punishment and the sheep to eternal life."
Thank you for that Bible reading. It's pretty clear that the sheep are the people who've tried to be good and kind during their lives, and Jesus will welcome them to enjoy everlasting life with him. The goats, though, well, they're the people who've been selfish or done bad things, and worse than that, they haven't owned up to their mistakes and said how sorry they were. Jesus will judge the goats quite harshly. This reading also tells us that it's Jesus who will do the judging. It's not for us to judge one another. We can't know everything about other people and why they might behave in a particular way, or how they stand with Jesus. So we can't judge one another. We might get it wrong. We leave the judging to Jesus. He can see into everyone's heart. He knows why people do what they do, and he can tell the difference between the sheep and the goats. Let's see how well you can tell the sheep from the goats. Andrew can't be here on screen with us today, but he sent a quiz for you. What a super quiz. Well, how many did you get right? Jesus guessed 10 out of 10 every time. I didn't, and I bet you didn't either. That will help us remember not to judge others too quickly on what they look like or what they do. We might get it wrong. Better to leave the judgment to Jesus, and for us to be polite and kind to everyone. It's time for our prayers now, and children from Norley School are going to lead us today.
Lord Jesus, may we keep other people in our hearts as we worship with joy. May we remember those who are fearful or crying today. Let us be filled with your compassion. Amen. God, you come in disguises, in a friend asking for a chat, in a person asking for help, in all calls of assistance. May we take the time to hear you, knowing that when we respond to one person, we are responding to you, who always responds to us. Amen. Lord Jesus, you reach down low to help us up. Make us the kind people who hold out our hands to others. Amen.
Let's bring all our prayers together in the prayer that Jesus taught us. We'll say the words together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. May God keep us as we work and as we play, as we think and as we act, as we listen and as we talk, and may he hold us in the palm of his hand. And the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, evermore. Amen. Next week, we'll be in the season of Advent, and Curate Hilary will be with you to tell you all about that. I'll see you again a bit later in December. Until then, do your best to care for one another and be kind to everyone. Keep safe, stay well. God bless. I'll see you soon.
While my heart is beating, while my body's breathing, my future's there for you to write. Though today I'm hurting, there's a new day coming, bright and shining like your smile. I won't give up, no, no, I won't give in, no, no, you are the tide on which I rise. I won't back up, no, no, I won't back down, no, no, this is the time for me to rise.